So as you have clicked on this video, you most likely already know what a VLOOKUP in Excel is. But what if I told you there's a way in Python to not only replicate the results of a VLOOKUP, but also unlock even more powerful features. In this video, I will show you a method that goes beyond the traditional VLOOKUP, giving you more flexibility to merge data. So without further ado, let us dive in. So here in my workbook, I have the following sheets. In the order sheet, I have a table which I have named table orders. In this table, we have a column with the order ID. And if we take a look at the returns table, we find that column again. However, instead of order ID, it's simply called ID. But in this table, we also get the information on the return reason. Lastly, in the shipping sheet, we have translations for each shipping mode. So, for instance, first class shipping corresponds to shipping mode number 1. Now, one way to consolidate all this data into a single table would be to use a VLOOKUP. I would like to add the return reason and the shipping mode number to my orders table. To do this, I have used the following VLOOKUP formula. Based on the order ID, it returns the respective return reason. Likewise, I did the same for the shipping mode number. Now, before I show you how to do the same VLOOKUP using Python, here's a quick tip. I have developed an Excel add-in named MyToolBelt. Most of its features are completely free. So, usually when a formula returns a no value available error, I prefer to include an if error formula. To apply it, I just highlight the cells with the formula, and instead of showing an error, I will display a blank cell. Once you click this button, you will see that the add-in wraps the VLOOKUP with an if error formula. If you want to install the add-in, I will drop the link in the video description below. Alright, now let us see how to recreate the VLOOKUP formula using Python. As a first step, I will store the data from each sheet in a separate data frame. For the orders, I will name the data frame orders. And then, just select the table and press Ctrl and Enter. I will repeat these steps for the returns and shipping tables. Once done, we will have three data frames: orders, returns, and shipping. With those in place, we can now merge these tables. And we will use pandas for that. If you are familiar with SQL, you will see it's pretty similar. Here is what I've did. I created a new data frame named MergeData1. Using the orders data frame, I merged it with the returns data frame. The identifier, as we saw, is the order ID. In the orders table, it's order ID. And in the returns table, it's ID. Okay, and I have chosen a left merge for this. Let me run this cell and show you the merge data frame before I explain the code in detail. Okay, so how can you tell which table is on the left or right? And what does a left merge mean? To illustrate this, I have prepared an image for you. The table on which we are performing the merge on is our left table. In our scenario, the orders data frame is the left table. That means the returns data frame will be our right table. In the left table, or the orders data frame, our column is named order ID. While in the right table, the returns data frame, it's simply called ID. The left merge means that we want to retain all the rows from the orders table, and for each row, merge corresponding data from the returns data frame. Essentially, that is just like in VLOOKUP. So we are retaining all the rows from the orders table, and if an order ID isn't found in the returns table, an error will appear. You will also notice that all the columns from the returns table are now merged with the orders data frame. If you only wish to display the ID column, you can remove the other columns using the drop method. Here you simply specify the column names you want to exclude. Running this, the table now looks like the one I've showed you at the beginning, where we used in VLOOKUP. Yet you might wonder why bother using Python. Well, the power of Python, and specifically pandas, lies in its flexibility. With pandas, you can use other merging techniques beyond just a simple left join. To illustrate this, I will set up a drop-down field. The options are left, right, outer, and inner. Now, in my Python code, instead of specifying left, I can link it to my selected cell value. When I run the code, the results remain the same, but I can now toggle between the other methods. For instance, a right merge fetches all entries from the returns table. If a matching entry exists in the orders table, it will display. So as the name suggests, it's the opposite of a left merge. Or in other terms, it's a left merge, where the left table would be returns and not orders. Okay, and now let's see what happens with an outer merge. As you might anticipate, the table extends, combining rows from both, the orders and returns tables. Here in my example, it might be actually helpful to also include the order ID to identify which orders ID have been returned that aren't listed in the orders table. So those would be the ones which are displayed here. And for an inner merge, the result shows only entries that matches between both tables. So this can be super helpful if you only want to get back the matching results. Lastly, to integrate this data with our shipping table, you can perform another merge. Since the column name in both tables is ship mode, I can also only use the on parameter. When I run the cell, you will see that we also get now our shipping mode number. If you would prefer to keep only specific columns, you can either drop the unwanted columns as I explained earlier, or specify the columns you wish to keep in a list, and then filter the data frame based on this list. Running the cell returns now only the order ID, reason and shipping mode number. And there you have it, a VLOOKUP in Python. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.